Hi, I'm Jeff Bradshaw from ElderlyIron.com, the website that everybody thinks is there for my own personal stuff. You remember this thing? Well, I got a lot of complaints about this, and I wore this shirt just for you. Now, if you have not seen the video installing this, then you click that little eye thing up over there on the screen, and that'll get you to the first video. Maybe you ought to watch that first, then come back to this one. You see what I'm talking about. Okay, so when I installed this, it had a purpose. The purpose was to lift the tire, to put it on the tire machine, because I can't lift the tire anymore. And I got several complaints about how dangerous this was, about the way I hung it up. But it was only there for the purpose of lifting the tire to put it on the tire machine, and it worked just fine. Okay? So then, I had every intention of coming back and reinforcing things, because yes, I would like to lift an engine with it, even though you can't move it. So if you lift the engine and you need to move the engine in proximity to the car, in relationship to the car, you have to move the car, because this is where it is, and that's where it's going to stay. So, today, you get to see me reinforce this thing, because there is an issue in that, if you watch carefully. See that? Okay! So, that has to get rectified. So we have mounting bolts to here. So for here, I'm just going to put L brackets and go right up against here and put a bolt through it. And that'll be just fine. This is where it supports most of the weight. On these two bolts right here, so I'm going to come across to these two with braces and we'll be done. Because I have another little project I'm going to make a video on, but I've got to be able to lift it out of the back of the truck. And yes, I am still injured. First, dimensions. I think I would like to come down. You can't see it with it over there, so I'm going to show you here. I want to put my hole 2 inches down from the top of that. So I'm going to have to bend it at 3 inches. So if I bend it at 3 inches there, and I bend it here, no, you stay here at 3 inches. 3 inches, right there, stay there. I suppose what I could do is I could mark that. And then just come straight across from that. To there is 14 inches. And then from there is 2 inches. 3, 14, and 2, 19 inches. Alright, so I've got some 1¼ inch flat stock. 2 pieces at 19 inches. We'll get to the angles later. Now there is a place in the vicinity called Rogue Truck Body, and Rogue Truck Body has trucks. They make dump truck bodies, and this is a taillight bracket off one of the gliders. This already has the 2 hopefully correct size holes in that. These will make the brackets that went by the motor. I'll have to lop that off because it's too long, and then lop it between the two. I already got my pilot hole drilled. Drill those out to 3/8, I think we'll be good to go. And that ain't exactly sheet metal. So that's pretty much all taken care of. And then there's this. I thought I had flat stock, but I guess all I got is bent stock. Yeah, that's pretty stiff. I just ain't got in me what I used to. Oh, I hate when it does that. Alright, got some cutting and grinding. Beating and wailing. I might even light the torch. Thank you. about close enough right there. It's not working out to my satisfaction. Got a soft spot in it. Or somebody welded in a hard spot. Like that. That's pretty much straight enough. Well, except for that part. Well, it don't look like you're gonna get any torch action in this video. Again, straight enough. So 38. Yep, I got 38 on this. Where's 19? 19? Yes, I know there's the matter of the kerf. It doesn't matter in my world. That is used up. So I go get my last new wheel. And the old wheel, you know, you're supposed to push down this little lock thing and unspin it. So I pushed down the little lock thing and I unspun it. Well, it didn't want to unspin because it was stuck on there. So, in my gripping, I inadvertently pushed the switch on. So, once I came back and I set this down on the bench and I plugged it in, it started up and fell down off the bench and busted my last brand new wheel. So now I must be more careful to utilize what's left of the largest wheel I have remaining, which hopefully is a decent quality wheel. Two inches. I need a hole 2 inches. And I need to make a bend at 3 inches. The other side I will mark where it falls on the bolt to make that one. Why, I happen to have a scribe right here. Let's see what kind of angularity is required. 3 inches down, about there, and right to the corner of this thing. And since I don't have one of them fancy angle finder gauge things, I use these feeler gauges. Up approximately there.
Why, I have not transposed. Yes, I have. Ow. There. Here's a reenactment. Twice. I did not compensate for the radius. It's all by eye.
By eye!
Well, you may just get some torching out of me yet. Okay, so if I wanted this to bend right there, that means I'm going to have to lift it up. When I throw the torch to it, two things are going to happen. Number one, it's going to get hot. Bet you didn't see that coming, huh? And the other thing that's going to happen is, this is at about, 38 degrees. So that's going to be a massive heat sink. So you can't just leave it down there and bend it over that. When you put your heat here, this is going to keep it cold. This is going to not bend. Where it's hot is going to bend. So that's kind of where I want my apex. Now, for those of you who are going to comment on how this should be properly done, when you were looking across the internet and you found Redneck Restorations, this old truck, just what part of Redneck did you not understand? Because if you're that type of person, you would also know to never light your torch like this. Well, okay, that's the way you're supposed to light it. Not quite, because I had the oxygen on. Oh, no. Never light your torch like this. There. Makes all the regulars happy. Makes all the newcomers cringe. I need some darkness for my eyes. I don't want to touch it. Yeah, I'm calling that good enough. Oh yeah. I come across here in that plane. I think I got right there. This one is the outside. This one is a little too steep yet. Or not steep enough, I guess I should say. Really didn't need the torch, but it sure was fun. Gotta keep those subscribers happy. Yeah, we'll accommodate that. Yeah, just drop it down like that. I don't really care. I like it. And this will be the inboard. Not that you have to mark both of them. Some of you like hearing the roosters in the background, some of you don't. Just can't please everybody.
Well now, seems to be a problem here. Because of that bend, it's hitting the bench. Let's see what we can do. It'll be at a slight angle, but who cares? Now let's see if I can light this the wrong way correctly. A little oxygen, a little fuel. Don't ever light it like that! So what I'm going to do here, when this is all said and done, it's going to make a 90 degree bend. Oh, look at that. It's all too beautiful. Alright. Marker? So I got to clear this bracket, which means I need to lock that much off of the end. I probably shouldn't try to move the ladder while I'm on the top of it. And the bolt falls about right there. No, I better make it there. Razor blades. And what do you say? Fooled you. So those two bends have to equal 90 degrees. So if I stick this up here like that, look at that like that, and I'm a little bit beyond. I found grease. That's lovely. That's acceptable. Right down to the nubbins. A wee bit long. Ladder again.
this side done.
3 3/4 inches wide. It couldn't have been like 3 1/2 or 4 inches. 3/4 means 1 1/2 3/8. 1 7/8. So we're dealing with 2 by 8s, which is 7 1/2, and this is, well, plus the bracket that hangs down, this is 7 3/8. No need to lop off the end. So I think while it's one piece, I shall open my top side holes. So with the vise fully extended, just barely goes in. In fact, it won't go between the jaws, but it'll go in the space below the jaws. Land shark.
Oh, Roger.
Well, since I broke my only new cutting wheel, I guess we'll have to do it the hard way, or the hot way. About right there. Well, the record button bandit strikes again. You didn't get to see that. But it's done. Theoretically, this should be fairly straightforward. Theoretically. Except for, that's the wrong socket. Let's try this again, shall we? Now this should be fairly straightforward. Should be. No! Hurts. I gotta get this done. No more Mr. Nice Guy. Just gonna be brutal from here out. What was I thinking? Some of you caught that already. Not me. Like I said, brutal. You better fit. You will fit. Why? It went right through the hole of the bracket on the other side. We'll take that. But I've got a 1/2 inch gap, so I'm going to have to do something about that. Just something else to do. I'll try to thread these in there. Whatever I get in, I get in. Whatever falls on the ground, falls on the ground. That, I believe, is going to be stable. Look at that. Nary a wiggle. Or wary a niggle. calling that done? I gotta get off this leg. And there will be another episode featuring this coming up as I try to... Well, I'm not gonna tell you. I'm just gonna have to wait. And until that time, for ElderIron.com, I'm Jeff Bradshaw. I almost happen to have a square right here. Why? I had a cane. Here it is. It is the one I want. You're the one that I want! You're the one I don't want. You're the one I don't want! All together now! Oh! Well, no. That was dangerous in and of itself. All together now. Don't ever light your torch like that. Okay, so that can go ahead and plant. Oh no! I've left my marker down below! Let's see if I can write... Now let's see if I can light this the wrong way correctly. I thought I was going to get away with doing this job without getting greasy. But no. Fit on the bucket?
No! Won't screw it down!
No! Thank you.